Dr. Ken Fuld, the psychophysicist at the University of New Hampshire, was able to demonstrate this in a simple and surprising way.
All colors are psychological phenomena. They are names that we give to our conscious experience. For example, there's nothing physically inherent about something that we call black. It's a psychological phenomenon in that it's a name that we give to the conscious experience that we have when we view something that looks black. For example, if you look at this spot here that I have projected against the wall, if we were able to surround it with a brighter surround, white surround, would turn black. That is, physically it would remain the same, but perceptually it would appear black. In the same way, a yellow or orange field would appear brown if we surrounded it with a bright white surround. Well, if you look at the screen over here, you see an orange spot. And if I put a white surround around it, a dim white surround, it still is orange. And it doesn't look anything like the brown pipe off to the right of it. But if I make the surround sufficiently intense, that orange spot will at some point appear to be nearly as brown as the pipe.
This is not a modern discovery. Leonardo da Vinci noticed just such an effect 500 years ago. He wrote, "Of different bodies equal in whiteness and in distance from the eye, that which is surrounded by the greatest darkness will appear the whitest." The results of observations such as Da Vinci's and the new concepts being advanced by the mechanical philosophers focused research on another component of what was clearly emerging as a multifaceted problem.
This opened the way for an entirely different study of color and a line of research that has been followed ever since, and that's to study light.
Modern scientists still find it very difficult to give a simple explanation of light. It is waves. It is streams of particles. It is invisible. Well, light is both waves and particles, although this was not fully recognized until the beginning of the 20th century. And light is invisible. Light does not require something very substantial to be reflected. Our atmosphere is filled with tiny dust particles, water droplets, molecules of gas, reflecting, re-radiating, and scattering the sun's light, which gives the sky its blue color and our sunsets their reds and oranges. Light has always fascinated man. Ancient scientists who studied light knew that it behaves in very special ways. For one, when light passes from one medium to another, as from air to water, it can change directions. A common occurrence of this is the way a stick dipped in water appears to bend as it penetrates the surface. Light also bends crossing between air and glass. The effect is called refraction, and it occurs whenever light crosses at an angle from a medium of one density to another of a different density. The amount of bending depends on the two media that make up the boundary. This bending of light is exactly what makes optical instruments such as microscopes, telescopes, even our eyes, possible. Refraction proved to be the key that unlocked the secret of light and color. In 1666, Isaac Newton, a man considered by many to be the greatest scientist of all time, penetrated deep into the mystery of color. In that year, Newton began a series of discoveries and achievements perhaps unparalleled in the history of science, including revolutionary work in optics, upon which our understanding of the relationship between light and color is based. Dr. Shapiro is the editor of Newton's Optical Papers, currently being published by Cambridge University. In his now famous experiment, Newton cut a small hole in the window shutter of his room, allowing a small beam of sunlight to pass through a glass prism. When he observed the way it was broken up into bands of color, he realized that refraction must be slightly different for each of the colors he saw. Although the effect of a prism was well known, it was generally believed that some aspect of the prism added color to the light. Newton made a new observation. He noted that instead of remaining as a small beam, the different colors continued to diverge. Newton measured the differences in their angles and found that red was bent the least and violet the most.
The next step that Newton made from there was to say that all of these rays of different color were in the sunlight from the beginning. Everyone before Newton had assumed that sunlight is a pure and simple substance. It enters into so many metaphors, the purity of light, it's used in religion.
Newton's insight that light is compounded of these different rays was to set the stage for all color and vision research. Although Newton's findings were presented in the 1670s, his great work, Optics, was not published until 1704. It cataloged a variety of experiments revealing other aspects about the nature of light, one of which showed that the decomposition of light into a spectrum could be reversed. In that experiment, Newton focused the diverging rays into a second prism oriented opposite from the first. He found that he could create a ray of white light that was indistinguishable from the original sunlight. He could even divide that reconstituted ray once more into a spectrum. Newton also found that light could be either compound or simple. Compound light, such as sunlight, was made up of different colored rays, while simple light was made of rays of only one color.
Newton gives the example of orange. Says you could take the orange from the spectrum, pass it through, and it'll come out still looking orange and one beam. But you can also make light that looks just like the original simple orange light out of a red and a yellow beam. But this one, when you pass it through a prism, will break up into two beams, the red and the yellow. This is what Newton called compound light.
Newton claimed that sunlight was the most compound color of all because it contained all colors. And he was the first to accurately explain how the rainbow was white light split into different colors as it refracted through water droplets, creating an arc of color in the sky. Another experiment proved that light was a key component of color and pointed up a problem with which designers of lighting sources must contend. When Newton placed a red object in a red beam, he found that it appeared red. But if he placed it in a beam of another color, say green, the object would appear dull gray or brown. He'd found that if a color wasn't in a light source, then we couldn't see it in the object either. It's a phenomenon we see every night on our roads. The high-efficiency lamps used all have limited colors in them. In the case of low-pressure sodium, the light is entirely of one color, or as Newton called it, simple. We see things because light is reflected from them. Objects are colored because they reflect some of the wavelengths in light and absorb the others. An object cannot reflect wavelengths that aren't in the light source.
The reason you see this picture here as being
as amazing as Newton's discoveries were, they didn't address the physical nature of light. But Newton, like others, had ideas.